Hypertension is defined as persistently elevated systolic or diastolic blood pressure of 140 over 90 or more respectively in subjects aged 18 years and above. Primary or essential hypertension accounts for about 90 to 95% of cases. There is no identifiable cause, but it is usually influenced by family history of hypertension. Lifestyle factors such as high salt intake, sedentary lifestyle, obesity, and alcohol use. Aging is associated with increased arterial stiffness. Primary hypertension is more prevalent in individuals of African descent. Secondary hypertension accounts for about 5 to 10% of cases. Specific identifiable causes include chronic kidney disease and renal artery stenosis. Endocrine disorders such as hyperaldosteronism, pheochromocytoma, Cushing syndrome, hypothyroidism, and hyperthyroidism. Coarctation of the aorta. Use of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, corticosteroids, or oral contraceptives, and obstructive sleep apnea. Hypertension is often termed the silent killer because it can be asymptomatic. Symptoms, when present, may include headaches, blurred vision, dizziness, chest pain, shortness of breath, and epistaxis. To diagnose hypertension, a healthcare provider will assess risk factors, family history, and symptoms of secondary causes. Perform a focused physical examination, including fundoscopy for hypertensive retinopathy. For accurate blood pressure measurement, use a validated device with proper technique. The patient should be seated and rested for 5 minutes. Arm should be at heart level and using the appropriate cuff size. And there should be two or more readings on at least two occasions. Routine blood tests complete blood count, serum electrolytes, urea, creatinine and fasting glucose, lipid profile, urinalysis for proteinuria, renal ultrasound, CT, or MRI for renal artery stenosis, and hormonal assays. Other tests include ECG and echocardiography for hypertensive heart disease, ambulatory or home blood pressure monitoring to exclude white coat hypertension. Management of hypertension often involves lifestyle modifications. Dietary approaches to stop hypertension include diet rich in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and low-fat dairy. Reduce sodium intake, limit alcohol intake, physical exercise of at least 150 minutes per week of moderate aerobic activity, weight management, aiming for a BMI of less than 25, smoking cessation, stress reduction with relaxation techniques like yoga or meditation. Pharmacological therapy is initiated based on blood pressure levels and cardiovascular risk. For stage 1 hypertension, start with one drug, usually calcium channel blockers like nifedipine or thiazide like hydrochlorothiazide. If the goal is not achieved, add angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors like enalapril or angiotensin receptor blockers like losartan to the above. If still not achieved, add a combination of angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors plus calcium channel blockers and thiazide. If not achieved, consider secondary causes. Refer for further assessment. At each stage, consider adherence to treatment before escalating treatment. Second-line agents include beta blockers like metoprolol and atenolol, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists like spironolactone. For stage 2 hypertension, start with dual therapy of calcium channel blockers, or thiazide plus angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors, or angiotensin receptor blockers. If target is not achieved, combine the three classes of drugs. If target is still not achieved, consider secondary causes and refer for assessment. Resistant hypertension is defined as a blood pressure of more than 140 over 90 in patients on at least three classes of drugs, including a diuretic in adequate doses, and after exclusion of false hypertension, such as isolated office hypertension, and failure to use large cuffs on large arms. In this situation, a combination therapy of angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors plus diuretic and calcium channel blockers is used. The goal of management of hypertensive emergencies is to lower blood pressure by 20 to 25% over the first hour with IV medications such as sodium nitroprusside and labetalol, and avoiding overly rapid reductions to prevent ischemic complications. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.